In this place, there once stood a city. The most famous city in the world. A city whose tragic fate has inspired poets and artists for 3,000 years. A city whose memory will far outlive the last trace of its physical existence. A city called Troy. But what happened here? What lies beneath the legend of the Trojan War? The story as we know it is told by the poet Homer, who may have lived around 700 BC, 500 years after the war is supposed to have taken place. It has been retold over the centuries. It is a tale of love and war. Long ago, a prince of Troy, Paris, eloped with a Greek queen, Helen, the most beautiful woman in the world. He took her back to Troy, a city by the Dardanelles in what is now Turkey, where his father, Priam, was king. The Greeks followed with 1,000 ships to take revenge. Their leader was Agamemnon, king of Mycenae, rich in gold. For 10 years they fought in the plain before the city. The heroes of both sides were killed. The Greek Achilles, the gallant Trojan Hector. The city was finally entered by the famous trick of the wooden horse, inside which the Greeks hid armed men. Troy was burned, its people slaughtered, sharing the fate of all victims of war. To even attempt to find answers, the first step had to be Schliemann. He defined the search, fired the generations who came after him with his romantic faith in the truth of Homer's Iliad. His obsession with Troy started, he claimed, with this picture in a book given by his father at Christmas 1830 when he was 8. Its childlike vision of the Trojan tragedy, he said, made finding the city the goal of his life. All he did later was to that end. A business career which took him from the California Gold Rush to the Crimean War and made him a million by the time he was 30. Even his love life became a step towards that ultimate goal of proving Homer true in his second marriage to the 16-year-old Sophie, a Greek girl who knew her Homer and who would accompany him on his quest. Schliemann has sold us all his fairy tale. Early in 1870, this middle-aged, retired businessman arrived in Istanbul, then the capital of Turkey. After a lifetime playing the markets of the world, Schliemann was about to engage in the riskiest speculation of his life. From Istanbul, he sailed through the Sea of Marmara to the Dardanelles. There, in the northeastern corner of the Aegean Sea, was believed to be the site of Homer's Troy. That April, he entered Homer's swift-flowing Hellespont, and from now on, Homer would be his guidebook. Following in his footsteps, it was easy to feel his excitement. Now, he wrote, I hope finally to resolve the great riddle as to where Troy was. The age of archaeology was about to begin.
Thank you.
Shanakali in Asia. Since medieval times, Western travelers had come through here looking for Troy. French, Venetian, English, all had walked these streets, Homer in hand, under the gaze of amused locals, buying provisions, hiring transport and guides, before heading south in search of Troy. The exact site of the lost city had long been the subject of furious controversy. Its general location, though, had never been in any doubt, somewhere above the flat green plain at the mouth of the Dardanelles. In the ancient world, it was believed that Homer's Troy lay under a little Roman town called New Ilium, which stood at the end of a long ridge, pointing down the plain towards the sea. In modern times, this idea had fallen out of favor. But here, at a hill called Hissalik, Frank Calvert had dug and found deep remains below the Roman foundations. This was where he persuaded Schliemann to look for Troy. And in 1870, this was where Schliemann came. In this place, the ancients believed, Troy had stood. Here, one said, no stone is without a name. I confess, wrote Schliemann, that I could hardly control my emotions when I saw it. Its image had haunted my childhood dreams. But did Helen stand on these walls and watch the heroes die for her? Did Achilles drag dead Hector here in the dust? The wooden horse bring down on the city a whirlwind of doom. I was convinced this was the place, wrote Schliemann. Iliad in hand I sat and imagined the armies marching to and fro in the plain, the fleet, the camp, the fortress of Troy on Hissalik. For 2 hours the events of the Iliad passed before my eyes, until hunger and darkness forced me to leave.